This week at Interior. Interior joined drone industry partners this week to take on the growing problem of unmanned aircraft systems getting in the way of wildland firefighters. The project makes fire locations publicly available to map providers that support UAS operations and alerts drone operators before they enter airspace over an active fire. Future technology will allow for the disabling of drones before they enter restricted airspace. Get details at DOI.gov. Secretary Jewell visiting Grand Canyon National Park this week, talking with rangers about the challenges and opportunities facing a park that serves more than 5 million visitors annually. Secretary Jewell and National Park Service Director Jonathan Jarvis introduced recently appointed Superintendent Christine Leonards, and she also joined students and USGS scientists gathering data on the river to better understand the Grand Canyon ecosystem. The USGS this week announced the discovery of large and highly enriched accumulations of natural gas hydrate in the Bay of Bengal. It's the result of a collaboration between U.S. scientists and the Indian and Japanese governments. Gas hydrates are naturally occurring combinations of gas and water and can provide producible energy. Get the full story at usgs.gov. A host of activities on tap across the nation next month as the National Park Service gets ready to mark its 100th birthday on August 25th. A solar car rally through 9 national parks, major and minor league baseball games, cultural and musical festivals, a new photo exhibit at the Smithsonian, free admission days to all 412 national parks, and so much more. Find an event near you at nps.gov. The Fish and Wildlife Service this week signed a historic partnership with Girls Incorporated to engage the nation's girls in nature and wildlife conservation. The agreement commits the two organizations to work together to help girls, particularly those from communities of color, to explore conservation and natural resource management. Find out more at fws.gov. BOEM Director Abigail Hopper toured the Virginia Aquarium and Marine Science Center in Virginia Beach this week, joining students from the YMCA learning about ocean and coastal sciences and conservation. She also visited Sandbridge to see the beach and dunes restored with sand borrowed from the Outer Continental Shelf through BOEM's Marine Minerals Program. That project has helped reduce damage to roads and other infrastructure from storms and hurricanes, restored wildlife habitat, and enabled Americans to enjoy the great outdoors. So you've downloaded the Pokemon Go app, roamed your neighborhood, even taken bike or bus trips in an effort to catch them all. Now it's time to meet the real-life American cousins to some of your favorite Pokemon. Whether you're looking for a tadpole or a deer mouse, you can find them on America's public lands. Just be careful, some of these special creatures are endangered, like the Sierra Nevada red fox, and they're all wild, so keep a safe distance. Check out the story on DOI.gov, and then check out these animals yourself with a summer visit to a national park, wildlife refuge, or other public land. That's this week at Interior.